So today our topic will be about listening comprehension. Okay, so this will be your practical in which we will be studying about listening comprehension. If you are going to attend in future like short talks or if you are attending or if you are even giving or hosting the lectures or the speeches about a particular topic, so how you should communicate and what should be if you are a listener. Okay, if you are the audience, suppose, then what should be your listening skills? So, listening comprehension we will be studying here. Okay, so the objective of the practical is to study about listening comprehension, listening to short talks, lectures, or speeches. Okay, short talks like a particular topic is given to you to a particular student, and then he or she has to speak at that particular topic. And then lectures like daily you are attending lectures. So, what should be your listening skills? If a particular speaker is speaking about a particular topic, then what should be your listening skills and what should be, and how you should understand that particular topic very well? And the speeches, if you are also delivering a speech, suppose, then what should be the particular way? So, this way we'll be studying. Effective listening. What is an effective listening? So, before understanding effective listening, you should understand that what is a language? Okay, language is what we speak. There are two types. First is our mother tongue. Okay, mother tongue is what? Like our, as a Indians, our mother tongue is Hindi, but foreigners, their mother tongue is English. So mother tongue is a very easy language because from when we have born and brought, so we speak that particular language. But learning a particular language, that is a foreign language, suppose, for us, like suppose English. Okay, so first you have to understand what is a language. So language begin with the ear, the life lives on the lips, so whatever we speak, and the tongue of the lives on the speaker. So whatever the language the speaker is speaking, suppose a particular speaker is speaking in English or Hindi or German or French. So first thing in listening comes the language. What is the language he is using? Okay, so what we have received is the language. First thing comes in our mind is whatever the language we have to use. Then listening should proceed speaking. Then the second thing is for listening, what the speaker is speaking, that we have to see. And is the secret of effective begging in language learning. This is impossible to expect a student to produce a sound or a natural sentence of foreign language. Okay, so if a speaker is speaking in some other language, then the audience will not be able to understand. So the first thing that you have to receive is what is the language is being speak and what is the way he is speaking. So these are things we have to listen. It should proceed with the speaking. Okay, because for a particular student, it will be impossible to understand in a language other than a mother tongue. So like if we are speaking in English, then for a student whose mother tongue is Hindi, so it becomes a little bit difficult for him to understand that particular language. So first thing comes is the language. Okay, then development listening skills. Then how we develop listening skills? At the first sight, it appears that listening is a passive skill. So I have told you that if we see for the first sight, means the first thing that comes in our mind about if we hear about listening skill is it is just a passive language. Just we have to listen to that particular topic. But listening is more than that. Okay, but this is not true. It is a receptive skill. It is not a passive skill, but it is a receptive skill. Receptive means we are grasping something. Okay, receptive, we are receiving something. It is involved in understanding the message. Okay, so when you are attending a particular lecture or a speaker or suppose short talks, so first thing that you have to understand is the language. Then the second thing is you have to understand the message, that on what topic he is saying and what is the message he is trying to give in that particular topic. Okay, so you have to understand the message also. And indeed, it is essential to the speaker in any interaction that words are being understood. Okay, so indeed it is very essential for the speaker. For the speaker also, it is very important that the audience should understand that what he is trying to communicate, what he is trying to tell to the audience, what is his message. Okay, it is going in a right way. Like interaction is there, that work are being understood, that is indicated, the nod, glances, body movement. Okay, so while the speaker is speaking about a topic, then his body language, his body movements are also is very important, because sometimes some things are sent are understood, they have to be understood without saying anything. Okay, so this contributes to the body movement. So the body movement is also very important. Like if you are in a particular, suppose for example, if you are going for an interview, okay, so your body language and your body movements, your eye to eye contact, these things are very important. Okay, so it will be helpful in your future. So what should be the body language, what should be the movements, because the movements also tells a lot that what you are trying to communicate to the audience. Okay, so you just don't have to read anything, you should try to communicate to the audience, and you should also with your body movements, you should try, like if I am saying that I am moving my hands, like, so you should try to do the body movements also. So this shows that you are putting efforts to make them understandable, a particular topic, and often by non-verbal sounds. Okay, non-verbal sounds here means without saying anything also, some things are understood. Okay, so sometimes the non-verbal sounds are also very important while communicating, because without saying anything also, the audience should be able to understand what he is trying to communicate. So listening skills can be classified into two groups. They can be classified into two groups, that is intensive listening and extensive learning, extensive listening. You don't have to go into the detail. You should just know these. There are two types of listening skills, intensive and extensive. Okay. Now the cultivation, namely speaking, writing, readings, a number of benefits would accrue to you by cultivating the skills. So after development, so we have understood that how to develop the listening skills. Okay, so after developing the listening skills, what will be the benefits that you will be getting? Okay, so what will be the benefits that you will be getting after developing your listening skills well? So these are written here in points. First thing is improve intellectual ability. So after developing your listening skills, you will be able to improve your intellectual ability. Intellectual means your intelligence. Okay, about intelligence about a particular topic. So you will be able to improve your intellectual ability to understand. Okay, so you will be able to understand, suppose anything, any particular topic, if we are saying about like greenhouse or global warming, any topic you can take. So what you will listen, and then you will develop your listening skills. After that, you will develop your intellectual ability, means you have understood that particular topic. Then after that, what you will do means you have received in your brain, you have received that message in your brain. Then after that, you will gather more information, you will try to search more information about that topic. So that means that your intellectual abilities are being improved. Okay, so improve intellectual ability to understand and evaluate the view and option expressed by others. Okay, so you will also be able to understand that whatever the others are expressing. Okay, and after that, you are evaluating the view, you are also evaluating, you are not just listening and keeping in your mind, but you are also trying to gather some more information about that particular topic. So in a way, you are trying to improve your intellectual ability in this. And then second point is enables to gather proper and accurate information, facilitating appropriate decision making. So what you will do next, you will gather more information and even more proper and accurate information. You will also try to find out more information about that particular topic, and you will also be able to make decision about it, that no, this is correct and this may be wrong. So you will also be, you should also be able to make decision about the topic. So decision making is also important. Then third is assist to establish support with co-worker quickly. Okay, so whatever, if you are working somewhere, so because you have developed your listening skills, suppose if you go somewhere and you work in a particular job, so the other, your boss or your co-workers, your colleagues, if they are saying something about a topic, so some people have that ability that they don't listen to somebody else. They just listen to their point of view only. So after developing your listening skills, you will also be able to understand about what other, your co-worker is trying to say. Okay, so we should, in a way, listening skills also help टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट अदर पर्सन इज ऑल्सो ट्राइंग, वॉट इज अदर पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. देन फोर्थ इज हेल्प टू इस्टेब्लिश सपोर्ट विथ को स्पीकर गिव्स हिज बेस्ट इन डायनेमिक एंड ग्रुप कम्युनिकेशन सिचुएशन. सो इफ यू आर डीलिंग इन अ ग्रुप कम्युनिकेशन, ओके, सो यू शुड बी आफ्टर डेवलपिंग योर लिसनिंग स्किल्स, यू विल बी एबल टू कीप योर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. If you are thinking about a particular topic in a way, then you will be able to keep your point. No, in my point of view, I think like this. So you will be able to understand. After developing listening skills, you will also be able to participate in the communication situations. If you are in a group discussion, so you will be able to listen to some other's point of view, as well as you will also be able to keep your point of view in front of all the others. So in a way, we are developing our intellectual ability in this way. Okay, then how honoring the listening skills. First, these are certain points that you have to remember in listening skills. First is prepare to, suppose if you are going for a particular debate or hosting, or if you are going to give a lecture on a particular topic, so whatever the points you have to remember is, first you have to prepare a list by gathering the information about setting the topic and the speaker. So first you should note down that what is my today's topic. If I will say my example, suppose if you take, whenever I take your class, I always make a list. I always write that today's date and what will be my topic today. Okay, so by making a list and by gathering the, and then after writing the topic, I gather the information. Like whatever I have to speak about that particular topic, so I always gather that information. So like this, I'm just giving my example so as to make you more understand about the particular topic. So first you have to make a list about the information that you want to speak, and then okay, the topic, you have to set a particular topic, and then you have to gather the information, you have to collect the information about it. Then have a positive attitude toward the speaker. So this point says that while the speaker is saying something and you are listening to that speaker, then you should always not think in a negative way. Oh no, he is not saying the wrong thing and I don't think so. You can have your own perception, but you should not think that no, she is wrong, like this. You should have a positive attitude. Okay, so after that you can gather your information about that topic and you can have your own point of view. So you should have a positive attitude about the topic, about the speaker, and you should also be open-minded. You should keep an open mind. Okay, so you should have a broad-minded personality. Okay, because nowadays you should have, if you are having a narrow-minded, then it will not be possible to you to compete. Okay, so you should have a broad mind about all the topics, all the things. You should have a broad mind, open-minded means you should be open, you should be flexible about thinking anything. Okay, so it can be wrong or it can be right. So if you are talking about anything, so you should have open mind. First, try to understand what is being said. So this is also very important, that if you are attending a lecture or a speaker or you are any seminars, anything, so what you will do, first you should try to understand what is being said, means what is being told to you by the speaker. So you should understand it. Okay, then evaluate it. Then you should think, you should use your own mind or the brain. You should use your own mind that whether it can be true, because if you will think, always you should try to think about it. You should not just listen it and just go means if you want to broaden your knowledge, then you should always try to think. Because if you see all the big scientists, what they are always thinkers, they are good thinkers, and they are also the good listeners. You should also be a good listener. Then first you should try to what is being said. Okay, so what you should try to understand what is being said to you, and then you should try to evaluate it. You should also try to think by your own way with reference to the context. So any particular context if you are dealing with, then you should also try to think after that. Then you should make questions. Before asking any questions, you should also think that what I am asking, is it sensible question? Is it a mature question? Then only you should put that question in front of the audience. Then ignore the distract. Observe the non-verbal clues. This is also very important. Non-verbal clues means those things which are not being said, that you have to understand by the body movements, by the body language. Okay, so you should also observe that. You should also observe it. Then ignore the distractions. So whatever the distractions comes while you are listening to something, you should ignore it. You should just ignore that distractions. And you should always try to concentrate on that particular lecture. Then refrain from interruption, premature contents, comments, direct advice, especially in seminars and meetings. So if you are attending a particular seminar or the meeting, you should always, first thing, you should try to avoid the distractions. You should have an open mind about that particular topic, and you should always think positive. Okay, positive attitude should be there. And after that, whatever the questions, if you have any query, then before putting towards the audience or to the speaker, okay, so you should try to think it, that am I asking a sensible question? Is it a good question? Okay, after that only, otherwise it will be like a mockery. So you should try to ask, you should not try to ask you should ask mature questions. It should have certain meaning. It should show that you are understanding that particular context. Having the patience while listening, the speed of thinking is much more than that of the speaking. So this point is very important, that you should always have, because while listening, you should always have patience. Patience is very important. If you don't have patience, then your listening skills cannot be improved. So patience is very important. You should have a patience while listening to the speech. So let the speaker complete that particular context or the topic, and after that you should evaluate, and then you should have your own point of view, and then you should, after recepting and after evaluating, you should try to gather some more information about the context, and then you should try to ask the questions or your queries. And so having the patience while listening, the speed of thinking is much more than that of the speaking, because speaking is very easy. Speaking on a particular topic is easy than listening to a particular topic. Okay, so you should also have that ability of listening. Listening skills are very few people have this listening skills, but it is very good. This skill is very good as a person also. And after that, last point is, you should always take notes systematically. Whatever the speaker, if you are attending a seminar or workshop or lecture, even the lectures also, you should note down the points. Systematically, you should note down the points. So that will be very easy for you. So these things, these points, you have to remember how we can improve the listening skills. Okay. So today here we will complete our today's topic.